Judge Dredd was released in 1995 and was a moderate success. It made its money back, but didn't make much of a profit. There are many factors that played a part in the film's failure, with audiences and critics. Dredd appeared in 2000 AD comics in 1977. Dredd is an American law enforcement officer in a violent city of the future where uniformed judges combine the powers of police, judge, jury, and executioner. He and his fellow judges are empowered to arrest, sentence, and even execute criminals on the spot. The character of Judge Dredd never removed his helmet in the comics. In the film, though, he removed his helmet within the first 15 minutes. With the casting of Sylvester Stallone, probably one of the most highly paid actors at the time, I think played a part in this decision. Also, the producers involved with funding the film wouldn't have argued with that choice. Having paid a lot of money to have Stallone in the movie, they weren't going to have his face covered up throughout the entire picture. Now, everyone knows Stallone is a very good writer and director, which he has clearly demonstrated in the Rocky films. Now, when you have a young, talented director who has only made a couple of films, his authority is going to be challenged a lot. So I think Stallone had also added his views and opinions to the final draft of the script, and to some of the decisions to the downfall of the finished film. The original draft of the film was written by William Wisher, who had previously worked on Terminator 2 with his good friend James Cameron. Supposedly his draft was a lot more different in tone to what the audience eventually got. The producer, Edward R. Pressman, who the previous year had released Street Fighter, brought in the director of that movie to do some rewrites, I guess to make it more commercial. Stephen E. D'Souza generally is brought in to add comedy and action to a picture. His work, unfortunately, is always very mediocre, especially the movies he wrote in the 90s. The script is the main problem. The introduction of comedy to the film takes away the serious tone of the comics, and the movie just becomes a run-of-the-mill action summer flick, which doesn't leave much of an impression. The casting of Rob Schneider is never a good sign. His character is just there for comedic purposes. He has a flimsy backstory about being a computer hacker, but the majority of the time he's just standing around not doing much. So his character just seems to be a complete last-minute thought, just to add some comedy to a film, which didn't need it. But it doesn't matter what film Rob Schneider is in, you're still going to think about the South Park spoof on him.
Rob Schneider is a Wall Street executive, with everything going for him. Only problem is, he's about to become a carrot!
I'm a carrot!
It's 24 carat comedy. A carrot. Rated PG-13.
The villain in the film, Rico, played by Armand Assante, is a well-accomplished actor, but plays his character so over the top it becomes hysterical. All his lines in the film are hammy. It feels like his dialogue is lifted from Street Fighter the movie, which Stephen E. D'Souza wrote. So I'm guessing he rewrote his character.
Of course.
Rico is basically a clone of Dredd and aims to take over the council and recreate a new breed of clones from his DNA. As I discussed earlier in regards to the director, Danny Cannon was offered a job after his impressive feature film, The Young Americans. Danny Cannon was born in Luton in England and was a big fan of Judge Dredd. He even entered a competition in the late 80s to design a poster for a possible Judge Dredd film. The poster was very much Blade Runner inspired and the poster was published. It must have been a dream job when he was offered the chance to direct Judge Dredd. Danny discusses his thoughts on Dredd during an interview on the set.
Judge Dredd was a comic strip that I had grown up with from a very early age, and images with it and storylines and characters within that had inspired me and remained with me, and it felt very adult. I mean, it was quite violent, it was quite political, and it was quite serious. Maybe we lack a hero that we can believe in. I mean, that was what appealed to me about Judge Dredd as a comic book hero. He didn't have any superpowers, he didn't fly, he didn't have a piece of lightning on his, you know, costume or anything like that. This guy was basically working for the government as a cop.
The film tries to combine a number of stories from the comics into one feature, which is done quite often in comic book films. The ones they used was The Day the Law Died, The Return of Rico, and Block War. There are a number of elements of the Judge Charles Quest, i.e. the Angel Gang characters, and the Apocalypse War. It's also put into the mix for basically no reason. Now, on a positive note, there is no denying that the film looks good. The production design is fantastic, and the special effects after viewing the film in HD still hold up really well. The movie is heavily inspired by Blade Runner. Danny Cannon fought with the producers to keep the film made in the UK, so he could take advantage of some of the best craftsmen in the industry. The production designer, Nigel Phelps, who later went on to design Alien Resurrection and the Transformer movies, discusses the challenges designing Judge Dredd.
The film's been a massive undertaking and but a very exciting and challenging one, because we've been trying to achieve something that hasn't been seen before in terms of opening the film out on an epic scale and making this a very believable city that stretches for miles. We're building everything, all the vehicles, the guns, all the props. You know, you can't go to prop houses to rent futuristic things. And we've sort of pumped up the scale on everything, so, you know, all the guns are, you know, they're monsters. And, you know, likewise with everything, you know, the architectural detailing, everything has been slightly, you know, increased in its bulk. But, you know, when you're looking at any, you know, wall surfaces or, you know, details, you know, you actually, you know, you absolutely believe that this is, you're looking at, you know, 150 years into the future.
The giant robot in the film is not actually from the Judge Dredd comics, but in fact from another comic published by 2000 AD called ABC Warriors. I'm not sure why he was used, but I'm guessing for its design and to have another villain to be thrown into the mix. It's beautifully designed by Chris Cunningham. Chris had previously designed covers for the Judge Dredd magazine. Danny Cannon made some great choices when getting the right people involved. The score to the film was originally going to be composed by Danny Cannon's friend David Arnold. The producers weren't enthusiastic with David being involved, because I presume they weren't happy with Danny being surrounded by too many of his friends on the project. David Arnold, as we all know, went on to compose all the James Bond films after GoldenEye. Jerry Goldsmith had signed on to score the film, but due to delays of the production he became unavailable, but he did compose a theme for Judge Dredd that was used in the trailer, and the music was also used in many other trailers in the late 90s, such as Lost in Space.
Regards to oblivion.
The duty of scoring the film was given to Alan Silvestri, who provided the music to the Back to Future films and Predator, and is now working on The Avengers. He composed a heroic march, and this became one of the highlights of the film. The movie had many popular bands contributing original music to the film, such as The Cure. The Manic Street Preachers were originally going to be on the soundtrack, providing a track called Judge Yourself. Their guitarist, Richie Edwards, disappeared in early 1995, and since the song was the last one written with him in the band, it never made it to the final soundtrack. The song was eventually released in 2003. To coincide with the film's release, Acclaim published a video game based around the film and the comics. It was received quite well by reviewers at the time, and praised for its detail and animation. Looking back at the film, it fails on many levels. It fails to please its hardcore audience by breaking many of the rules in the comics, like removing his helmet and having a love interest with another judge. The film is very cliché in its plotting and execution. There is plenty of action to keep you interested to a certain degree, but once Stallone removes his helmet, he is no longer Judge Dredd. He is Stallone playing a generic Stallone character. The first 10 minutes of the film, he does a good job with the role. And some angles, he looks just like his comic book counterpart. The producers made a fatal error not trusting its director and for hiring one of the top actors at the time. It's always best to go with an unknown or a young upcoming actor to take on the role of a superhero. The film can be seen as a guilty pleasure to many, but for Judge Dredd fans, they hated it with a passion. With the new film coming out later this year, let's hope it sticks to the rules of the comics and aims to please its hardcore fanbase.